Abeka, Kato Sulaiman, Muhammad Mariam, Salma Muhammad, Ali Hassan, and Jennifer Nalunga, all directors of a Nile Treasure Gate company, arrested a few weeks ago following investigations into Judith Nachintu organ harvesting case. 38-year-old Judith Nachintu, a mother of five children, had in 2019 traveled to Jeddah, Saudi Arabia to work as a domestic worker, only to be returned critically ill last year. Findings done at Mulago National Referral Hospital confirmed that Nachintu's right kidney was mysteriously missing. Despite their arrest, the charge awaited the Attorney General's affirmation, hence the delay.
Twin Kampala District, found in Uganda and Saudi Arabia, you recruited, or you transported, or you facilitated, or you transferred Nachintu Judith by means of fraud or deceit or abuse of power, position of vulnerability for purposes of exploitation, and the offense was committed by a syndicate.
Today, the five directors of Nile Treasure Gate Company who reportedly recruited Nachintu were arraigned before Nakawa Chief Magistrate Elizabeth Akulo and charged with three counts of aggravated trafficking in persons. These, who had hidden their faces under scarves and hooded jackets, all denied the charges. Prosecution, led by Joseph Chomhendo, informed the court that investigations into the matter were still ongoing.
Your Worship, in the circumstances, we are praying for an adjournment to enable us to continue with our inquiries.
Chomhendo further revealed that due to the magnitude of the case, they intend to expedite the investigations quickly such that the case can be committed to the International Crimes Division of a High Court for hearing. The accused persons were remanded until 14th of March 2022. The men were sent to Kitalia Government Prison, while the females to Chigo Prison.
Comes again in court formation at 9 o'clock. 8215, accordingly remanded to Kitalia Government Prisons, 8, 3, 4, and 5, and 6 are remanded to Chigo Government Prisons, accordingly. Seven. I repeat.
Still in court, the Court of Appeal in Kampala has declined to grant a temporary injunction for the release of lawyer Male Mabirizi from prison. Mabirizi was committed after arrest by police to serve 18 months imprisonment over contempt of court.
Within the same process, that when you have a main appeal, then you have an intellectual application, can be raised as a ground of appeal in the memorandum.
Yes.
So my point of reference is that this court has not addressed its mind with those provisions, which are so clear that at the time of preparation of my memorandum of appeal in application 843, since even these orders have application 843, I would raise these matters as grounds of appeal.
Right now we are from Justice Sekana's hearing, where Male Mabirizi applied for setting aside the orders which directed that he be imprisoned for 18 months and pays a fine of 300 million. When we went for the hearing, Justice Sekana informed us that as a matter of principle, he has decided to step aside from this case.
On February 15th, High Court Judge Justice Musa Sekana directed that Mabirizi be sentenced to 18 months imprisonment after being found guilty of continued contempt of court for disparaging judicial officers via his social media accounts. Justice Christopher Mandrama today ruled that Mabirizi's plea to stay execution of the 18 months cannot succeed because he has not applied for the same.
To entertain prayers to restrain or stay orders issued by the High Court on 15th of February 2022 until and unless the applicant challenges those orders by means envisaged under Rules 6 Sub Rule 2 and 76 of the Rules of this Court. in the premises the prayer to suspend the applicant's imprisonment and set him free pending his application or appeal, which has not been commenced, cannot be granted for want of jurisdiction. The cost of this application shall abide the outcome of the main application or the appeal as may be determined by the court, comprising of an uneven number of justices, not being less than three. Dated at Kampala, the 25th of February, 2022.
Rachel Nachwala reporting for the news.